According to the Minister of Disaster Preparedness, Relief and Refugees, 2,562,000 kilograms of maize flour and 1,281,000 kilograms of beans have been distributed in Karamoja sub-region in the period between May to July 2022 as relief to avert hunger and starvation that have been ravaging the area.
We have got some food reserve where we are going to distribute, where we want to distribute those places. But all of a sudden, Karamoja people started dying in Karamoja. So we said, okay, let the hailstorm victim first wait. We first divert everything to Karamoja. That's the food which has arrived Karamoja. That's not the food from the farms allocated for Karamoja. The funds allocated for Karamoja has never been used yet. It has not yet arrived, just arriving. So make it clear that this, what we are doing now is for the general disaster that we got.
The food that comes from the ministry targets people who are the most vulnerable. But for this time, almost everyone in the region has been affected because of, one, this insecurity. As the minister already alluded to that, it's an insecurity situation that has caused a lot of famine. And then also, secondly, because of the weather patterns. So in the previous season, we had a challenge. We didn't succeed in terms of harvest. And then secondly, of course, insecurity. So the locals were not in position to go to the gardens because of the challenges, because most of them would be attacked in the fields.
While presenting a report on the state of hunger and starvation in Karamoja before the Parliamentary Committee of Parliamentary Affairs, the Minister of Disaster Preparedness, Hillary Onek, noted that although the media reports that 900 people have died of hunger in Karamoja, the figure has not been verified by the government.
Now, about the death in Karamoja, figures have been conflicting because some of my colleagues from Karamoja, just in a meeting, you find that, the figures are 400. All of a sudden, one come and burst and say, no, they are now 800. I said, where do you get your figure from? Where do you get all those figures from? So, and that's what prompted us to go down to see actually how many people have died. We found out that actually, if you take about 16 people who have died,
however, Onek reported that the bigger numbers of people that have died in Karamoja have succumbed to waragi, not hunger. Onek explained that many of them consume the locally brewed waragi without eating, which is a big health risk.
Out of more than half out of drinking waragi when they are having no food in the stomach. No food in the stomach with waragi here, you go. So, I mean, these are the kind of real situation on the ground. Not that they all die of hunger.
Onek also decried the lack of a direct budget for disaster preparedness, leaving the ministry to rely on begging the Minister of Finance every time disaster strikes in the country. He proposes a 200 billion annual budget for disaster preparedness.
We wish if we have a budget, annual budget, we don't necessarily need to spend it. After all, normally the ministries don't spend all their money. If they can budget something like 150, 200 billion, they are standby, whereby any time we requisition to buy ABC, we get the money.
What is happening? It is a rich region. NGOs have been there. Pictures have been flowing from our country to other parts, begging for money. Why is Karamoja not changing if all the donors are impacting positively? We need to get that list. And we had made a decision that we want to do an assessment for 5 years, from 2017 to date.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.